Vihine bechi.
Hina zu shilamayla min ha-seichel, hu ha-nikra godal. Now this idea that's beyond intellect, that's what's called the lottery. Kumo shekasu b'Torah or b'Megillas Esther, sof dibur ha-maschil ki Avraham. Lo yadonu.
Like it's brought in Torah or in Megillas Esther.
And when it says Avraham didn't know us, because it's beyond the Seichel. From Keser. The Inyan HaGoral b'Mikdash Chulu, and the concept of the lottery in the temple and so forth, Shesham Inavonos Mavdilin Chulu, that over there you do not have a state of where the sins separate and so forth. And therefore the lottery is specifically in front of Hashem because there's no separation. What does it mean in Lifnei Havaya?
It means the higher than the level of the name of Havaya,
Yud Chochma Chulu, because the name of Havaya corresponds with Hishtalshlus, Yud Chochma, and so forth. The beginning of the name of Havaya starts with Yud. Aval HaGodol, Hu B'Bechina Shel HaMayla Me'a Chochma, but the lottery is a concept that's beyond wisdom. Val Derech HaMavur B'Makom Ocher Al Pi HaMaimer B'Breishis Rabbah, and like it's brought in another place. On the verse and on the statement in Bereishis Rabbah, or is it Ma'aseh HaTzadikim Chulu, that the light
that refers to
the acts of the righteous, the creation of light. I don't know if he desires the light or the dark until you find a verse.
Hulu.
And that's why you have two lotteries. One lottery is for Hashem, and the other lottery is for Azazel. Havaya, Havaya corresponds with the holy emanation, or the world of Atzilus. We also give the lottery to the other side, Chinyan Magasus, which is the concept of haughtiness and coarseness.
Im tagbihi kanesher, if it lifts itself up like an eagle, b'chinas
To a level that's beyond the order of creation, asher sham kechashecha ke'ora, that there your darkness is like light, v'samam yisbidayim titafes chulu, and the spider with its hands it grasps even in the king's palace, because the king doesn't bother to look at it on such a high place. Fine, mashakas b'dibor maskil v'yavekish. Mikol makom misham oridcha num havaya. But nonetheless, Hashem says from there, I will bring you down. Hashem says, kigam la'asid musa. Because also in the time to come, when you have the revelation of the essence, nemar v'haya havaya li that Hashem will be for me for an elokim. That in comparison to the essence that will be revealed, the concept of Shem Havaya will be compared to how now Shem Elokim is lower than Shem Havaya that it receives from it. Shal yadun nimshach shefa ha'atzmos, that just like Elokim, to the Elokim you have the divine flow, so too in the time to come, when you have the revelation of Atmos, so Havai will be like the Elohim.
Yutal HaGoral, Kol, and that's what the verse says, that in the chest you will place the lottery, but from Hashem is all its judgment.
Meaning that the
The Goral is from the Etzem.
But the Spashtus and Shefar is from the Shem Hashem. Because the Goral is from a level that's higher than Shem Havaya. Ayin bebreishis rabba pasha tzadik ches ki inyan ha-Goral hainu shulamayla mibichin estam vedasa musag. Shemibichinas chokhmo bina, that is because the lottery is an idea that's beyond wisdom and understanding that's grasped in the concept of wisdom and, of chokhmah and bina.
It's more an idea of silence. That's how it came up into God's thoughts. It's not being brazen, God forbid, but it's hidden wisdom. Rather, it's hidden wisdom.
It's just simply that below this is something that is beyond wisdom. In comparison to us, completely beyond our understandings. Mekain kasav bigeras hakodesh sof simin zayin einum bebechinas tam vedas musag, that it's not in, so it says in Tanya, that it's not in a concept of a reasoning, an explanation that is grasped by us, elala maila mebechinas hadas, but it's beyond our knowledge. Shekach ala b'machshav alefanav yisbarech, that's how it came up into his thought in front of him, may be blessed. And below, this is seems to us as if it was a lottery, completely. And so too it is in a person, the singular, highest level of the soul, shalamayla maseichel b'chinas keser, that's beyond the intellect, the concept of the crown. V'enyin b'chinas zu b'avodas Hashem, this concept in serving Hashem, yish levo'er b'kama b'chinos, we can explain in a number of ways. Ha'alav shezeu b'chinas emuno, the first is that this is a concept of belief. B'ma she'ein haseichel v'adas masig, on the level that the intellect and the knowledge cannot grasp, like it says, the righteous will live with their belief, and it says, and they believed in Hashem. So to its brought in a mimer from the Alter Rebbe,
concerning the idea of Purim, there you also have a concept of lotteries.
Al Shem HaPur, Purim is called because of the lottery. V'zeh Lashono, and this is what he says, Achi ne be'emes she'eshnei goralos, but the truth is that you have two lotteries. Ki inyan ha'goral ma'ashi i'ef shel odem lahasig b'sichlo, because the concept of the lottery, that a person can't grasp in their intellect, livchor b'davarahu, to choose this thing, so michal hagoral, so he relies upon the lottery. Eich yipol, however it'll fall. Kumo kein sarich kol adam lahapil goralos, and so too a person needs to throw down lots. Then ushiyed benafsho shiyafsho lahasig besichlo, that is on something that in inside oneself one realizes you can't grasp with your intellect. Va'achar kach
lismoch al hagoral, and afterwards to rely on this lottery, dahinu al emuna ad kanashono, that is to say, on belief.
V'zeu inyan ashreinu matov chilkeinu
u'manayim goraleinu, and this is the idea of how praise to us, how good is our portion, how pleasant is our goral, how pleasant is our lottery, goraleinu davka, specifically a lottery, that b'shebechines that this refers to this belief. That's an inheritance from our forefathers. He nikra goral, that's what's called the lottery. Like it says in Tehillim, we say that you support my lottery. That is to say, because we need support from above, because it's beyond intellect. So Hashem supports it. Our emuna is strengthened from above. And to explain this matter, it's explained in the Maamar about how you should know today. That at times it says you should know the divinity of your father, that you have to specifically have knowledge, ולפעמים נאמר באמונה אסור יחיה כנ"ל, and sometimes it says that you have to have belief. והעניין, the concept is שלהאמין שהקדוש ברוך הוא ברא את העולם, מאין לי יש, that this, to believe that the Holy One, blessed be He, created the world from nothing to something, ומחיה ומהווה אותו, and enlivens and creates it, על זה אין צריך אמונה. And this, you do not need belief, שעל זה נאמר אתה הורס על הדס, that on this it says, you showed us to know, שאו מרום עיניכם וראו מי ברא אלה, lift up your eyes and see who created these, אך דס זה מגיע רק בבחינת ממלא כל עלמין, but this knowledge comes specifically from the concept of that which this knowledge is specifically in the mamale, this that which fills creation you can understand and see, but in the concept of the divinity that encompasses creation beyond the creation, this idea that Hashem isn't changed by the creation, is not affected by it, and all the creation in comparison to this level is only from a glimmer of the name and so forth from his name. So that's not understood by us. Bedas, and with knowledge, came bechinas emuna, only in a concept of belief, lahamin b'Hashem, to believe in Hashem, shehu yisbarech inu begeder almin chulo, that he may be blessed, is not in the order of worlds at all, ve'in shum shinu yetzlo yisbarech, and that there's no change in front of him, bein kodem shenivra ha'olam, bein achar shenivra ha'olam, from before the world was created and after the world was created, it's all the same.
Completely nullified.
And this is not something we can understand. Rather, we have to have emunah, and this belief, which is beyond intellect, is called the crown. And this is the concept of the lottery, that Hashem supports our lottery, to believe in the concept of soviv. Man, I'm good. All I know, canal, and how pleasant is our lottery, and so forth. Habechin, habeis, and so what's the sect? An explanation of the goral. Binyan pirush goral ba'avoda in service of Hashem. Well, derech mashin is poured b'dibor amaschil re'ei anochi no sein shubechin is a bitulei love yisparech. So it's a concept of nullification to him. May be blessed. Shalamayil medas faskala, which is beyond knowledge and intellect, hamusag, that's grasped, that whatever the goral comes out to, that's what you're going to do. You don't have an opinion in it, rather you nullify yourself to the opinion from above. Vinekra b'chinas maskil al davarks, and that it's called to understand something, uksiv maskil etan ezrach yichulu. And so this is concept of the hidden intellect, the strength of the neshama, that's going to shine. Ezrachi is lashon asid, that's going to shine into the neshama. So this is concept of the shorash neshama, ratzon pasher, which is a simple will, bli shum tam v'seichel musag chulu, which without any given intellect or reasoning that's grasped behind it, rather it's simply a bittul to what's above. A certain Kabbalah soul, v'nimshach mebichinas Yisrael alav b'machshav v'chulu, and this kind of bittul to the hidden wisdom comes from our essential root and in the hidden wisdom, in the Hashem's thought that came up first, because the neshamas are rooted in the essential reasoning behind creation. Therefore, we don't need an explanation of why Hashem wants us to do this or that, or any concept of Ratzon Elyon. Rather, we simply are nullified to it. Hainu b'chinas hagod al kanal, and that's the concept of the lottery b'shem Igeres HaKodesh Sof Simin Zayin that we brought in from Tanya, Igeres HaKodesh, before. V'ayin v'dibur ha'maskel v'lo avachulu v'yavachulu, and look what is brought about the mimer on Pasha's Balak, that Hashem did not desire Bilam, and he changed the curses to blessings, binyan kots, or shal yud, concerning the kots, the kots of the yud. shebenefesh, in the soul, that essential bittul nullification of the yud, of the point of the yud in the soul, the crown that's nullified vayin sof dibra maschil ki karovei lecha davar. Look on the mimer about this idea of how this thing is very close to you, be'inyan avoda be'bichinus soviv shebenefesh, in the concept of service to Hashem, in the surrounding concept of divinity with that's within the soul, so that this thing is close to you because you have a certain soviv that's in the soul. Shalomayel ma'aseichel, that's beyond intellect. When you're namasiris nefesh, it's a concept of giving up one's life for Hashem. Sheinaseichel mechayev lemasiris nefesh chulu, that the intellect does not obligate you to have self-sacrifice. It's against intellect. Ayin sham, look over there. But it comes from the soviv that's in the nefesh. Kim b'chinazu, mi b'chinis yichidah shebin nefesh shalomayel ma'aseichel. But this comes from the essential singularity of the soul that's beyond intellect, essential attachment to Hashem. By Mashikosu b'dibur maschil moshin nigashil harafel. Look what's brought in the mimer about how Moshe drew close to the darkness. Sham nizbor od inyan zeb omek yoser. This idea is explained on a deeper level. V'hine eretz hibechina simuna. Now the concept of the land, that we're dividing the land, so the concept of the land is imuna. He brought before it's a concept of Gan Eden, but here he's explaining further that's a concept of belief, shebichinas malchus, because the land corresponds with the level of malchus, and malchus corresponds with emunah, vekemoshikas of shochin eretz reemunah, like it says, dwell in the land, and shepherd belief, vekemoshikas of dibramaschul v'yadaita yom hanal, like it's brought in that mimer, that you should know today about the difference between emunah and knowledge, that Eretz is Emuna. The Holam Abba Hu Bina, Sheba Yizkal Lusatik. So the concept of the Eretz itself is the land, but the Olam Abba is more correctly attributed to Bina, that in Bina you have the revelation of Pnimiya Sakesar, of the pleasure in the works of creation, the Atik. That this is the main concept of the world to come, which is a revelation of the divinity that encompasses creation. Mechinas Keser, the concept of the crown. Like it's brought in Tanya concerning the idea of how it's known with that with an arousal from below. That this level will be revealed in this world to all of the righteous that will get up for the revival of the dead with a revelation of Soviv and Keser. That is that in the time to come you'll have the elevation of Malchus Imuna into Keser Olam Abba Gamla Maila Mebichinas Ima, that is even higher than the concept of the mother of Bina, of Ima, Kamo Shekasuv, Sufti Buramas, Kilodonis, Visimchi Bas, like it's brought in the concept of to rejoice the daughter, the Malchus will be elevated. Kamo Shekasuv, Al Pia Maimer Vahia Bayomahu Yetsu Maim Chaim Yerushalayim Chulu, like it's brought upon the statement that on that day, living waters will come out of Yerushalayim, Beparsha Shlach Kuf Ein Aleph Aleph. And this is the concept of that the earth, the aretz, will be filled with knowledge. That in this concept of emuna, of malchus, of aretz, will you have a revelation of knowledge, of das, from soviv kol almin, that the encompassing divinity will come in a panimius, into das, into knowledge. That is through the mitzvos we draw this down. And this is the concept of shepherding belief, drawing into the belief, a concept of the pnimius. And this is the idea that you will be for me, a desired land, Valkain Begoral Dafka Techaleka Arat, and therefore specifically with the lottery you'll divide the land, Shualide Bechinas Havoda, which is through a concept of service to Hashem, the Bechinas Sovev, and a concept of surrounding Shibenefesh that's in the soul, the surrounding divinity in the soul. That's where you're going to draw down this concept of Goral, Shuanikra Goral Kanal, that the encompassing level of the soul, that's what's called the lottery. You're going to be Mechalei Ka'aretz, you're going to draw down this portion into the Emuna, and into the level of Malchus Vayinu Shenem, or Shochin Eretz. It says, to dwell in the land of Emuna, and to shepherd the belief, Ki Bechinas Eretz Chefes Yiskalus Soviv Kol Almin, that this concept of the desired land is a revelation of the encompassing divinity of Sovev, Zeudaf, Kal Yidei Havodah Gamken, that specifically through service of Hashem, Bebechina Sovev Shebenefesh Kanal, with the encompassing Sovev in the soul, Vezeu She'amar Rabbi Yochanan Ben Zakkai, and that's why Rabbi Yochanan Ben Zakkai says, Ein Yodea Be'ezu Derech Hulu, that I don't know which way they're going to take me, Af She'asa Kol Yamav B'Torah Mitzvos, even though Bipnimius, his whole days he was involved with Torah and mitzvos. Ki ekar iskalus olam haba b'chinas soviv kol almin zeloidei b'chol meodecha, because the main revelation of the world to come, the concept of the encompassing divinity, that's specifically through with all your might, b'chinas yechida, the singular concept, the highest level of the neshama that's beyond the pnimius, v'zeo ki ner mitzvah v'torah or v'derechayim chulu, and this is the concept of how a mitzvah is a candle, and the Torah is light, but the path of life and so forth, so this concept of the path of life, is which is the world to come, or it comes after and is beyond the concept of the candle of the mitzvah and the Torah is light, rather it comes through the concept of rebukes of musar, to have a revelation of the essential quality of the soul, comes from a concept of self-sacrifice and accepting the yoke and giving up one's life and so forth, the concept of b'chol me'odecha. So you have b'chol nafshecha, maybe mitzvahs, b'chol me'odecha, b'chol vavcha, maybe mitzvahs, b'chol nafshecha, maybe tefillah, and b'chol me'odecha is a concept of Mesiras Nefesh. So you have the mitzvahs in Torah and Mesiras Nefesh. And look what's brought in the Mimer about the candle of Chanukah. How Beit Shammai says that in the first day you light all eight candles and so forth. Concerning the idea of with all of one's might, which is beyond the mitzvos. Concerning the idea that in the place where the Balei Tshuva stand and so forth, the tzaddikim can't even stand, because they reach this level of bittul and keser, that there's someone in this marketplace who is a person that merits the world to come. Ein sham shual derech begoral techalek chulu, which is a concept of that you will divide the land with the lottery.